The following segment is sponsored by Smith Injury Law and 300hurt.com.
We've had several discussions with attorney Richard Smith involving critical mistakes people make after car accidents. It seems one action that certainly can't help you is giving a recorded statement without an attorney present. Richard Smith of Smith Injury Law is here. Good morning.
Good morning, Morgan.
The same is true involving a workers' comp claim, right? What can go wrong if you provide a recorded statement to insurance?
Well, the first thing you should ask yourself when the adjuster asks you to give a recorded statement is, why are they wanting to record it? And the reason is because they want to ask you questions which could hurt your case, you know, or help your case. But in general, if it's just going to be questions about the case, then they don't need to record it. So if they're going to record it, there's a chance that they're going to ask you questions that could devastate your case, whether it's a workers' compensation case or an auto accident case. But it certainly happens quite a bit in workers' compensation, where sometimes the factual details of how an accident happened can mean a lot more than the average person believes. And just describing what happened incorrectly can cost you a lot in your case.
Yeah, a lot of details about time and speed and things that you really wouldn't probably have an accurate response for. Are there any instances where it is okay to give a recorded statement?
I would always have an attorney first before making that decision, because you don't know what you don't know. Mm-hmm. And if you give a statement without an attorney, you can make a big mistake in your case. We see it all the time where, you know, let's say, for example, you're a passenger in a car accident and the driver runs into a deer, okay? And maybe the driver was going too fast for conditions. Maybe the driver wasn't being attentive. Maybe the driver did something wrong to cause the accident, even though there was a deer that also was partly to blame for the accident. Well, if you don't have an attorney and you don't understand those issues, you might completely tell the adjuster that the driver did everything possible to avoid the accident. And guess what? The deer didn't have insurance. So if you're involved in an accident with it, and it could be all the deer's fault, if that's the case, then the driver's not at fault. But a lot of times you don't know that those answers when you're giving a recorded statement. Maybe the driver was going too fast. They weren't paying attention. Maybe the deer was out in the road long enough that the driver could have avoided the accident. There are things that could have happened that maybe the driver is at fault. But if you don't know that and you give a statement without an attorney, you're liable to destroy your case before the case ever gets off the ground.
Absolutely. Well, one thing we know for sure is workers' comp claimants need to report those injuries immediately, even if they don't think they're too badly hurt. Talk about why that's important.
That's very important, because if you don't report the injury, it's amazing how everybody forgets that it happened. You need to report the injury immediately. And if it's something that's a mild strain or something that's not that serious, you go to the company nurse, you go to the one doctor's visit, you get released, everybody's fine, no problem. The problem occurs when the injury is more severe than you think it is initially. And for whatever reason, you're afraid to report it, you're being discouraged to report it, you think you're gonna get in trouble by reporting it, and then a week or two goes by, and then the problem you thought was going to go away, it hasn't gone away, and now you really need to see medical attention. Well, now I guess what's going to happen, they're going to deny your claim because you didn't report it in time. Even though the law allows you more time than that to report it, most companies will deny a claim if it's not reported immediately upon the injury occurring.
Yeah. The sooner the better, and I know you respond quickly too. Tell us how you operate over at Smith Injury Law and who you serve.
Well, we serve people in North Carolina and South Carolina, all upstate South Carolina and western North Carolina, who are involved in car accidents, workers' compensation claims, or who have Social Security disability claims. And we talk to that person if they've got a case. We immediately get involved. Most of the time, we can sign a person up over the on the internet through a Sign Now program, or we can meet with them on occasion. We try and limit in-person meetings because of the COVID-19 pandemic, but we can if we need to, and we also can do it by mail. Mm-hmm. And then once the person is involved as a client, that we can do most of everything over the telephone or by email. That's how it works.
Well, you make it easy for sure. People can get in touch with you by calling 300-HURT or visiting 300hertz.com. Richard Smith of Smith Injury Law, always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you, Margaret.